entertainment, sports in just 60 seconds. But first, this political announcement paid for and authorized by the President Ford Committee.
There's a change that's come over America, a change that's great to see. We're living here in peace again, we're going back to work again, it's better than it used to be. I'm feeling good about America.
Today, America enjoys the most precious gift of all. We are at peace.
America is at peace. We're at peace with the world and at peace with ourselves. And a great many of us feel that the steady, dependable leadership of President Ford will keep America secure. We know we can depend on him to keep us strong at home, to ease tensions among the other nations of the world, and to make peace with freedom his highest priority. Keep President Ford in charge. He's making us proud again. Paid for and authorized by the President Ford Committee, Western Hughes Treasury.
This is Dave Martin in New York.
And Bob Fouts in the West.
With Sports World on the American Entertainment Radio Network. Bobby Orr's comeback with the Chicago Blackhawks may not last very long, or reported to be in excruciating pain, and he fell three times in the Chicago-Montreal game Wednesday night. The hockey superstar has had five knee operations, but was named the most valuable player in the Canada Cup Series this fall. He signed with Chicago as a free agent for $3 million, says he doesn't want to sit out because of that big salary, but now doctors say he's going at it too hard, should rest the knee for a week to 10 days. Last night, the Washington Capitals beat the Colorado Rockies 2-1 on Jerry Meehan's second goal of the season. WHA winners were New England, Cincinnati, Indianapolis, and Winnipeg. In the NBA, the Lakers won their first home game. More from Bob.
Ex-superstar Jerry West, who led the Lakers for 14 years as a player, made a successful home debut as coach last night in Los Angeles as the Lakers came off the road with a 1-3 record and beat Atlanta 118-101. Kareem Jabbar jamming in 29 points. And after it was over, West said winning at home is the thing to do.
We've set some team goals, and we're going to try to win every basketball game at home. It might not sound realistic, but that's exactly what we'd like to do, and we won our first one tonight. And this is where you're going to make the playoff, by winning at home.
Jerry West goal owner Jack Kent Cook heartily endorses.
Dan Ronfield's tap-in with 35 seconds to play lifted Indiana over the New York Nets 90-89. Phoenix won its first after three losses, 95-82 over Chicago. Seattle slipped by Detroit 106-103, New Orleans over Washington 111-93, and Kansas City ran by San Antonio 130-102. Tennessee basketball coach Ray Mears is suffering from nervous exhaustion, will be lost to the Volunteers indefinitely. Earlier this week, Mears suspended his star player Bernard King for repeated brushes with the police and training violations. Philadelphia Phillies have signed right-hand pitcher Wayne Twitchell to a four-year contract, reducing the number of free agents in baseball's reentry draft next week to 25, 19 American leaguers, and 6 from the National. That's Sports World. Dave Martin with Bob Fouts for American Entertainment Radio.
Worldwide News from the American Entertainment Network. Benson Mills reporting. The election is getting nearer, the race is getting closer, and the candidates are making their home stretch kicks. Both President Ford and Jimmy Carter are working the big states today, including Texas. On his way to Texas this morning, Carter stopped in Tulsa, Oklahoma, to tell an airport rally he could help restore America to greatness.
The greatest resource of all we have is the 215 million Americans who are tough, courageous, patriotic, idealistic, who are willing to fight when the going gets tough. This is a thing that's given us a great courage about the future. We don't mind facing next year because with a Democratic president, a Democratic Congress, and a strong people, we can overcome our difficulties and restore the greatness to our nation. That's what we're going to do.
Carter will visit five cities in 13 hours today. Now this.
When the leaves come off, put the white collar on. The two-in-one collar from the heart.
Summer's gone, but fleas and ticks are still in season. So keep a Hearts 2-in-1 collar on your dog or cat this fall. To kill fleas, ticks, even ticks that cause dangerous Rocky Mountain spotted fever, the Hearts collar is always in season.
When the leaves come off, put the white collar on. The 2-in-1 collar from Hearts.
Casper Roots Carpenter. How do you spell relief?
Well, when I have heartburn, I spell relief. R-O-L-A-I-D-S. Rolaids.
Dylan Evans, restaurant maitre d'.
Acid indigestion, just like it's spelled on the label. R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaids spells relief. Each Rolaids consumes 47 times its weight in excess stomach acid. Linda Farmer, secretary. How do you spell relief?
For gas, here's how. R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaids spells relief. Use only as directed.
President Ford will campaign today in three states with a total of 94 electoral votes, Texas, Pennsylvania, and New York. Winning those three states would put a candidate more than a third of the way to victory. The president arrived in Texas yesterday with the news that he had pulled into a near-dead heat with Carter in the Lou Harris ABC News poll, and he was obviously elated.
When you've got momentum and the opposition is trying to put their finger in every dike to try and stop the erosion, Obviously, we've got the momentum going, and they're frantic and frustrated and frenzied, and, I just feel good about it.
The president's next stop will be Pennsylvania, one of the states rated a toss-up in the polls. Sporadic shooting and shelling is reported in Lebanon, but on the whole, the ceasefire continues to hold. Arab leaders are now trying to decide the next step in their plan to end the Lebanese civil war. The beginning of the end of the Lebanese war supposedly came when Syria decided to send its forces in on the side of the Christian rightists. ABC's John Cooley reports the Syrians are apparently going to stay a while.
A visit to the Syrian-held areas of Lebanon yesterday confirmed the impression here in Damascus that Syrian President Assad's commitment to restoring peace in Lebanon is a long-term one. Lebanese shopkeepers and farmers are now using Syrian as well as Lebanese money. An officer of the pro-Syrian faction of the divided Lebanese army told me he thought the Syrians should stay in Lebanon for at least 4 or 5 years while the Lebanese rebuild their own army. He said the biggest peacekeeping job the Syrians now have before them is to disarm all of the extremist gangs in the country. John Cooley, ABC News, Damascus.
Secretary of State Kissinger's top troubleshooter for Africa, William Shoffley, has arrived in Geneva. Shoffley will try to help get the Rhodesia talks on the track. Rhodesian Prime Minister Ian Smith is refusing to budge from the Kissinger plan to bring the black majority to power in 2 years. The black nationalist delegates reject the Kissinger plan entirely and demand black rule within a year. Senator Hubert Humphrey will leave Memorial Sloan Kettering Hospital in New York today. He's been recuperating from the October 7th operation, which removed his cancerous bladder. He says he's in unbelievably good physical shape. The 65-year-old Minnesota Democrat is running for re-election. He's expected to win easily. He says he expects to be able to serve a full 6-year term. This is ABC News. High schools in Colorado Springs, Colorado, are showing a movie called Claude, a 3-minute cartoon about a boy who's always being nagged by his parents until he finally makes them disappear by pushing a lever on a little black box he's built. Some parents have tried to have the film removed from schools, saying it makes parents look stupid, creates a generation gap, and goes against family traditions. School officials say the movie stimulates discussion about a lack of communication within the family. They have overruled the parents, so it looks like Claude will have a long run in Colorado. That's news. News. I'm Benson Mills for the American Entertainment Radio Network, a service of ABC News.
Hello, Americans. This is Paul Harvey. We have a lot of things to talk about today. Two things in particular. How nice girls really are interesting, and I can prove it. We're going to discuss what's going to happen if the silent majority does not vote this time around. If the silent majority does not vote. And we're going to talk about something interesting that's happening in Ohio, too. But first, I want this message